What's going on, my trainer club? Today, we're going to check out the top tips to help you guys get ready and prep for Abra Community Day and Pokemon Go. So, welcome to the trainer club. Here we go! Welcome back, everybody. Let me know in the comments below, how excited are you guys to do the Abra Community Day and Pokemon Go to get your shiny Abras? I am excited about this ever since they were released Go Fest by accident. Now they are not the rarest shiny in the game. They're gonna be one of the most common shinies in the game. So let me know if you guys are ready to go. And before we get into this, I just wanna let you guys know that I am going to be having a meetup. So if you guys do wanna come out to the meetup, I'm gonna be at Skokie Sculpture Park, which is going to be in Illinois for the PvP Mega Tournament that is gonna be going on in Chicago. So check my pinned comments below to get the details. It's going to be on my Facebook page. So if you are anywhere in the Chicagoland area, it's a very long, extremely densely populated place to play Pokemon Go. So I can't wait to see some of you guys out there. So now we're going to get into everything we need to know for the Abra Community Day in Pokemon Go to make sure you have all the details and are set and ready to go. So number one, it's going to be on Sunday the 15th from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. if you are in the Northern Hemisphere. And if you're in the Southern Hemisphere, it's going to be from 3 to 6 p.m. So there's going to be shiny Abra potentials everywhere, so make sure you guys are ready to go. And it's going to be 3x catch XP for the bonus. So if you guys are looking to get some XP and get a close to a XP goal or a level 40 or a new level for whatever player range you are, that is going to be a great time to help you out. But just remember that friendship XP is going to be the number one thing that we are going to be focusing on. So there are also going to be a moveset. We're going to have a 2-hour window following the event to evolve to get this. So now we're going to get into everything we need to know, starting off with tip number one. Tip number one is going to be starting to lead up to this event. So if you guys do, and I have mentioned this in my pre-prep videos, have an Abra that is going to be a 100% IV or a really good one, you can start working towards your buddy bonus if you foresee the moveset, which we don't know as I'm filming right now, to start getting it close to the best buddy, which is gonna bump up the XP of this Pokemon and make it more powerful if you choose to use it for PvP or for raid battles, right? So that is definitely something you can do. So also leading up to the event, I would suggest starting to stock up on any friendship bonuses. If you're 1, 2, 3, 4 days away, make sure to contact that person or open their gifts as much as possible. Get that friendship bonuses because you have a few days until we get to Sunday. Also, make sure to have your bags cleaned out. I would suggest having 500 spaces to be safe, because since we now have PvP and we now have the meta attackers, we're looking for perfects and we're also looking for different stats, low attack, high defense and stamina, so it's not as easy to just search string these Pokemon anymore. It's going to be more conscious checking, and so that means that you're gonna have to have a bunch of different ones saved in your bag, and it's gonna be more tedious during the day to go through and delete these Pokemon that you do not want. And then you're gonna have to decide, like, do I wanna keep this one for trades afterward as well? So that's why I'm saying just have 500 spaces open so you guys are ready to go. Also, I'm gonna suggest pineapple berries because although Abra is pretty prevalent when it becomes windy conditions, if it's not super windy by you, it's not gonna happen very often. Abra's also a Gen 1 Pokemon, so it's going to become more extinct as other generations come out. So you're definitely gonna wanna consider that when taking all your pineapple berries into this. If you want more Abra candy, you don't have enough Abra candy, you're newer to the game, you're going to want to have probably 200 plus pineapple berries in your bag. And Abra does run frequently, but I am going to assume they're gonna change that based on this day. So typically, an Abra is a throw your ball at it, it's either a catch, if it doesn't catch, it's going to run, which is going to mean you're gonna want a lot of Ultra and Great Balls just in case they don't change this, because the preferable method to catch this Pokemon is going to be the Ultra Ball, which is gonna help you stock up. Two more things you're gonna want too. Have your Golden Raspberries enough that when you get your Shinies, you can go ahead and use the Golden Raspberries so that this Shiny does not have the potential to run away if they do keep the flea rate pretty high. And then number two, I'm gonna suggest that you guys have some type of items. I always use star pieces on these events unless I'm running really low and I don't plan to spend money or get more coins to use on star pieces, because this is gonna be like the most concentrated spawns and playtime that we have. So although it's still not 3x star dust, which is a lot more effective, I am okay having my incense running. I'm okay with having my star pieces on during this time frame because I still have a pretty good surplus and I only typically do this once a month. You're going to need lucky eggs, but if you don't plan to use lucky eggs every single time, you do not need 6. You just need, I would say, for at least 30 minutes to hit your friendship bonuses. So if you are not a pay-to-play player, you're gonna start needing to start stacking up on your gym coins 8 hours per day, which is gonna get you 50 coins leading up into the event, which is gonna take us to tip number two. Tip number two is going to be, make sure to, as we're getting closer to the event, so this is on the event day, you're gonna want to be in a downtown area to hunt. You want a lot of stops, you want a lot of gyms, you want places that to replenish your items and to give you research tasks. So not only do you want to have research tasks in the immediate area, but you wanna have stops that you can kind of stray off your path and get even more. Typically a downtown city park is a great place to do this. Another thing that you may consider is using premium lures. So during this time frame, the premium lures typically spit out 50% of the boosted spawns and 50% of the regular spawns, but since it is community day and they are taking over other spawns, they do spawn things a lot quicker. So if you are in an area that is not so condensed, you may consider doing this, because if you don't have so many stops, you're gonna need these spawns to turn over more frequently in the lure so you can maximize. So having premium lure modules that turn over faster are gonna be a great idea for you. I always recommend having your timer set up 11:30, 12, 12:31, 1:32, and then you have 2 hours to trade and evolve all your Pokemon, which we will get to in our later tips. So now we're gonna go on to tip number three. Tip number three is gonna start off with getting into the event right when it's about to start. So 30 minutes prior to the event, do not catch any Pokemon in the immediate area, because those Pokemon have potential to switch over to Abra potentials, which could get you a shiny. Number two, before the entire day starts, do not complete any research at any of the stops in the immediate area, because during the community day, they will not just replenish. If you already did that stop, it will not have a new research during the day. So do not complete your research before the event starts. And right when the event is going to start, you're going to want to pop your friendship bonuses right up front. You wanna time it out with people. You wanna put your lucky egg on. If you don't choose to use your lucky egg for the entire time, so be it, but at least do 30 minutes and hit some of your friendship bonuses, and then start stacking up for the next month as well if you don't plan to lucky egg quite frequently, because this is the best and biggest bulk of XP that we can possibly get. And then don't forget, we have the Giratina altered form raids going on, and we also have the Go Battle League event, which is gonna have shiny timber potential. So if you do see any of the Giratina raids or you see the timber raids, it may be in your best interest to raid them to try to get yourself a shiny or a good one. And let's not forget about the Abra 99-cent event that you can pay for in the game. I highly suggest you guys do this, because it's just a dollar for one big old duck hunt fight going on over there. So you guys are gonna be able to get 13,000 Stardust, you're gonna be able to get a Puffin, you're gonna be able to get 3 incenses as well as a Rocket Radar. So for 99 cents, this is definitely something that I suggest you guys check out. Really not all that much money, but it's definitely something in my opinion that it's going to be worth it. So if you choose to do that, you're going to have to purchase that as well, which is gonna lead us to tip number four. Tip number four is gonna be during the event. We want to know what weather is gonna boost the Abra along with the 100% IVs for the Go Battle League as well as the regular meta attackers. So, weather conditions boosting Abra is going to be windy weather. So if you do have windy weather, you're gonna get a Stardust boost and your Abras can go all the way to level 35 in the wild, which is going to be super prime for you guys. So getting into the 100% IVs, we have 575, which is gonna be task level 15. So if you do get research tasks during this day that we're gonna get level 15 Abras, 575 is gonna be the one to look out for. And then if we're able to raid for it or hatch it from eggs, 767 is going to be the level 20 100% IV. And so if you have any other weather conditions besides the windy weather, it's going to be 1150 at level 30, which is gonna be the max CP you can catch it in the wild. So 1150, anything close to that, that's gonna be a really good maxed out CP IV Pokemon. And then if it's going to be windy weather, you can catch it all the way till level 35, which means the 1150 is no longer relevant because it has 5 more levels to go up. So it could be 1150 at a level 33, which is not 100% IV, but in the level 35 100% IV, we are looking at 1246. And as far as the Go Battle League, we are looking at the Alakazam, which is really gonna be the only effective one to use, which we will check out in the best of the best video to see how it tears up as a meta attacker and how it does in the Go Battle League and everything else. It's going to be a 1-15-15 at level 18, so that's gonna be below 2500 dust per power up for the Abra, which is gonna give you the 100% IV for the PvP Great League as far as this Alakazam. And then going into the Ultra League at level 30 and a half, so that's gonna be 5,000 dust per power up, is going to be 0-14-15. So those are the two ones to look out for. If you guys do want to pause when we are talking about them and check out any of the other top 15, you can definitely do so as well. I highly suggest that you guys are going to use the skip animation catch trick. So if you guys do want to check it out, you're definitely gonna wanna check it out up here. Master that, that is so crucial. It helps you catch so many more Pokemon. You can bury it, you can then go ahead and run from that Pokemon very quick and easily. You don't have to wait for the animation of the catch, especially in your dense spawn area, and you are catching and encountering a lot of Pokemon, which is going to lead me to tip number 5. Tip number 5 is going to be post-event. So you're obviously going to want to go through and check all of your IVs for PvP stat potentials. You're going to want to either go to GoStadium.club, or you can use PokeGenie or anything like that to start checking them. GoStadium.club is going to be the most precise for you guys as far as the PvP IVs, and then obviously you can search for 3-star and 4-star afterwards to see all of those, and you can then go ahead and sift through and see which ones you want. You're going to want to trade as many as possible. Remember, we have 100 trades per day, so if you can preferably find somebody over 10 kilometers. The ideal would be 100 kilometers, but it's gonna be kind of hard for you guys to get together. Would then be to trade as many Abras as you can. Over 10 kilometers is gonna get you 2 candy per trade, so give you additional candy and a lot of potential to get lucky Abras, which is gonna be ideal. Then you're gonna wanna evolve all your Abras in this 2-hour window, as well as if you have any lucky friends, you can set something up. You can go ahead and evolve your shiny Abra all the way into Alakazam, and then lucky trade it for a lucky shiny Alakazam if you so desire, which, and then,
oh, the noise out here today.
And then you're gonna want to consider doing some other things, which are going to be evolution. So I personally do not keep shiny Abras and shiny Kadabras. That's just not what I do. I evolve all of mine into shiny Alakazams because they are going to have the moveset, which is the most desirable thing ever. So if any players have not been playing and they come back, they're gonna want a shiny Alakazam, but it has to have the Community Day move, because these movesets are typically, for the most part, gonna make these Pokemon effective. So I evolve all of mine, and then I even evolve some regular Abras with the moveset so that people that come back and may so desire one of these Pokemon, I can go ahead and use those if they don't want to, or if I don't want to spend the extra Stardust to give it to them. So that's gonna do it, guys. Make sure to have your bags cleaned out. Make sure to have all your items stocked up. Make sure to have everything prepped and ready to go. Your friendship bonuses, you are in a location that's gonna rock for you guys. You're in downtown areas with gyms, Pokestops. You haven't done any research tasks or caught any Pokemon in that area, especially leading up to there. And if you're in the Chicagoland area, you feel like PvPing, or you just wanna come and play, Skokie Park is where I'm gonna be. So thank you to all my likers, commenters, subscribers, Patreon members, and everybody who takes their subscriptions and support to the next level. I'm gonna see you out on the next video. Peace.
I just want to take a moment and sincerely thank all of my Patreon members, everybody that has taken their subscription to the next level and chosen to support me on this platform. I greatly appreciate you guys as a growing channel and really trying to grow and improve as much as I possibly can. I really appreciate the extra support. You guys mean the absolute world to me. I cannot wait to connect with you soon, and I appreciate you guys all for being a part of the Trainer Club. I will see you guys out on the next video.